as Americanas, Lauren Junior Clayton.
Lauren Clayton operates at the World Series level. Has a notable past win over Edgar Munoz of Venezuela.
Marks.
Round one.
Primeiro round.
The Frenchman's partner is here in the arena today, Estelle Morsley, who's competing in the women's program.
For Tony Yoka, you mentioned that long wait to come into this Olympic Games. A bit of nerves, but that'll be helped with that little uppercut there. More accurate, crisp punches from the French fighter. Clayton, when he gets in there, can cause some trouble. And Tony Yoka taking his time, aware and maybe slightly wary of the power of Clayton. Hasn't opened up too much in super heavyweight boxing. It's dangerous to exchange. So you see that the earmuffs go on, the big high guard from the French fighter.
Good right from Yoka. Maybe just protected by the arm of... Good jabs. With both boxers firmly planted at super heavyweight. They just eyeball one another and...
Certainly is, he means business here. Clayton Laurent Jr. cutting off the ring well. Let his hands do the work here. And in the super heavyweight division, that chance is always magnified. Hence the caution from Tony Yoka of France. Good tactics from the Frenchman, very professional, very measured.
Just not being remotely able to tag Tony Yoka of France to a place in the next round of the super heavyweights. Tony Yoka takes a unanimous points decision win over... Scheduled for three-minute rounds, super heavyweights, much taller. Yoka of France in the red against Ishaish of Jordan. For a place in the semi-finals and a guaranteed medal, bronze at least.
When you are the shorter man in this kind of a contest, it's all about making the differential work in your favour. He was a little careful about letting go then, Ishaish. Maybe with the thought in mind, I don't want to expend too much energy too soon, because every one of those shots takes plenty of energy.
Trying the uppercut there, Yoka, and he narrowly failed to land it.
It's how you use what you've got.
Powerful of both hands, Yoka. The overwhelming favourite, Tony Yoka of France in red against Ishaish of Jordan.
The profit of all that experience he's gained since London And if he can keep winning now, the possibility in France that he can become what they call a crossover star, not just a star athlete, but a star celebrity. He has the personality to go with it. The profile has been growing in the last couple of years, especially since that World Championship win.
Jordanian celebrating a landing blow. Took a couple in return.
I'm not sure this is the best I've ever seen Yoka box, actually. And one of the reasons is because he is punching down quite a lot. And in fairness to Yoka, he has contained him well, hasn't he? But when I watch him, I often think of Yoka that there's so much more to be brought out of him. How good could he be?
I think the next stage is going to be very interesting. The very next bout in the semi-final, it will be a step up. Yoka will know that. Great effort from Ishaish of Jordan, right to the closing bell.
And what a reception he's getting from the crowd.
Unanimous decision.
Senhoras e senhores, o vencedor por decisão unânime do canto vermelho.
Tony Yoka of France, medals in Rio. A bronze at least takes his place in the semi-final of the super heavyweights. Scheduled for three-minute rounds, super heavyweight semi-final, both guaranteed a medal, bronze at least, but going for that gold medal bout, Tony Yoka of France in red against Filip Hrgović of Croatia.
And the one thing about super heavies, blinking, you can miss it sometimes. Both of these men have a punch that can stop an opponent outright. Well, good work to the body and then back up. Yes, it was taken by the gloves, but he was hoping that the rip to the body, the left rip to the body, would drop that right glove, which is why he went back upstairs. Yoka will know that. And if that continues, a man with the speed of Yoka for a big man, wait for the big right hand straight over the top of the jab. The jab to come out, him to follow it straight with that right hand. It'll happen before the end of this fight for sure.
Tony rings around the arena. With that left jab of Yoka has been the key punch in this opening round and likely to have caught the judge's eye. Just
so even when you're a super heavyweight from France, you've got to have a romantic nickname, obviously. Lives in Paris, the city of romance, and may need some bragging rights because his girlfriend's already through to a gold medal that we'll see later on today.
Punches of the Frenchman in red, just getting through a rather open guard of Hrgović, whose main intention is to land that big right. And some damage, I think. For a super heavyweight, the face of Tony Yoka doesn't show too much of what he's been through in the past. This is a man who doesn't get hit very often by the look of it.
Hrgović doing his best, but he's being outboxed at the moment.
Tremendous right there from Yoka.
And in the first round, we saw it. A little left rip. Oh! Slip. We saw a little left rip and left hook combination. We haven't seen that again. No sign of any ligament damage done. He couldn't be back out there if he had rolled his ankle.
Trying to take advantage, though. That will be hurting. Under 90 seconds for Hrgović to find the big right hand.
And not without the possibility either.
And that footwork would have been slowed down with that ankle injury.
He's really close.
Open mouth there, Tony Yoka, in the final seconds of this super heavyweight semi-final. Great effort from Hrgović. Here's the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by split decision.
Senhoras e senhores, o vencedor por decisão dividida, no canto vermelho.
Tony Yoka.
Representando a França.
World heavyweight champion for 11 years. Round one. Tony Yoka of France in the red. Joe Joyce of Great Britain in the blue. The Olympic super heavyweight title on the line. Just an inch between them, 6'7", 6'6". Joyce dominating in terms of the number of punches thrown. And that's what I got to say, that's what I like about Joyce. He's gone upstairs, there's no way through those gloves. Straight keeps the work going to the body.
Measured performance so far.
Yeah, and tremendous core strength as well. But against a man that can drop him with one punch as well, we've got to say. Either of these boxers could end this. Nice right hand towards the end there from Yoka. Great first round, super heavyweights. So the Frenchman in red is in front on two judges' scorecard. Joyce in front on one. One thing about Joyce, he's kept on coming this way in every fight that he's fought.
Yeah, and he's doing it again here.
And he's slowly... Another good round. Can Joyce continue at this level of intensity? He's on the phone to the Australian light heavyweight Paul Anderson, glove box earlier today, and he felt that Yoka would get this victory purely through crisper punching.
Yeah.
He might be right.
There's a lot of fighters in this situation, you'd say, well, there's no way that they can turn it round.
Nice jab from Yoka, went straight through. Like that work from Joe Joyce, though, again.
Still plenty of time left in this third round for it to swing back in the favour of Joyce.
I could swing with one punch.
Yoka overconfident, if anything, here.
Yeah, a bit of an Ali shuffle there. Nice right hand, though. Joyce just keeps on coming. He's a train. The left uppercut there.
It's really a case of a surgeon against a steamroller here, isn't it? Because I think Yoka's argument is I've been the more accurate, more incisive puncher. But weight of shot coming from the man in the blue vest.
Yeah, trying to become the first British super heavyweight since Joshua, of course, 4 years ago, but also Audley Harrison back in 2000. Coming to the last 30 seconds of the fight. Tried the right rip, followed by the right hook. The hook missed. Big clubbing hook on that occasion. Again, looking to shorten him up with the uppercut. Nice jab. Joyce, good uppercut scores. It's a big finish.
I can't see how on the cards a big finish is going to be enough. He needs a knockout finish. And Yoka's not going to give it to him.
No, but they've both won respect from this capacity crowd here. Marvellous fight from both men. Tony Yoka, Joe Joyce. They can both be proud.
Against the mighty Man Mountain.
It's a shame that there's got to be a decision. It's a shame there's got to be... Don't want to use the word a loser.
Split decision.
It's close.
Olympic champion.
Senhoras e senhores, o vencedor e campeão olímpico por decisão dividida no canto vermelho. Representando a França, Tony.
So close.
It got even closer at the end because Joyce actually claimed the third round on two of the three cards.
Yep. The Turkish judge had our winner winning all three rounds.